Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani, and today I'm taking part in the Cheek Challenge. This was started by Dr. Steve Weiner down in the Panhandle of Florida, and he took us through 3D imaging and a patient injected on one side of the face with Voluma, which we've had for a couple years now and have had great success with, and the newest product, Restylane Lyft, on the other side of the face. Part of the purpose is to compare the products, but for me, there's also two other reasons. Firstly, to compare the techniques that we use, and I'll go through that when we inject the patient, and also to kind of look at the mid-face and create even more awareness that if we fill the mid-face and the upper face, we often don't fill the folds, which is why our patients come. They come to see us because of folds, but really the face is dropping, and the awareness of filling the upper face creates a more natural look. It's subtle to the fact that patients look rested, they look rejuvenated, they look younger, they don't have this odd forward projection. But one of the reasons we need to create awareness is because people still have in their mind that they can come in and get one or two vials of filler, rejuvenate their face, and get rid of the folds. Well, you can get rid of a nasolabial fold with one vial on each side, but when you start to take someone, let's say age 45 to 55, and you want to rejuvenate the facial region with two vials of filler, it's pretty much impossible unless you focus on these folds. But the downside is it makes the patient look not natural, but to their eye, because they're looking two-dimensionally, they do see the filling of the folds. So it takes a little more volume, and that's where we have to educate our patients when they come in, that to rejuvenate and to fill and create a youthful, natural look, what's taken 40 or 50 years of aging is not in just two vials. And I would challenge people to take a teaspoon and put that teaspoon of water into a cup and have a look at what the amount of volume is produced. And that is equivalent to 5 syringes of filler. Now with 5 syringes, we can all often do a nice job. We don't need to have the full 10 or 20 cc's that they lost from their face, which is the reality. So that's part of my reason to do this as well. And we were called out by Dr. Steve Weiner in the Panhandle of Florida, and I'd urge you to go and look at his video on YouTube. And if you search the Cheek Challenge on YouTube, he will come up. So I want to talk a little bit more as we inject the patients in the interest of time. So let's go and take a quick peek at 3D imaging, which is, I think is very important to create a plan for your patients, and then we'll go to the injections. Okay, I wanted to show you just quickly about 3D imaging. If you're subscribed to my channel or you watch my other videos, you know and you've seen a lot about 3D imaging. But with our patient today, and here she is up here, I wanted to just kind of show you what we can do. Here's a side profile, and really, here's where we're focusing today, the high lateral cheek. Now, in America especially, a lot of women, younger women especially, want volume in the front. It's kind of a trend right now. It can make the face look a little fatter, certainly. Can make the under eye look a little bit better. My preference is a little bit of filling through here, which you'll see. Then you can touch up and fine tune the under eye. But this is really the home run area to create beauty, to create lift, to create an angle that the patient may have had before, or a slightly new angle that creates that beautiful high cheekbone. And you'll see in a lot of the magazines, a lot of the models, kind of run their makeup and run the cheek right down almost to the oral commissure. And you can do all those things with fillers and create that. But most importantly is to restore and to lift. Why? Because of loss of bone, especially in women, perimenopausal, postmenopausal, you lose bone. Changes in fat, the fat pads, muscle, and collagen loss, the face slides. So by lifting this area, by doing the proper technique, you can hold the face up, prevent the slide, which prevents all those folds, or if they've already occurred, create some lift and filling. So we'll go to the video in the essence of time here, and I'll talk more as we fill, but I wanted to show you the beauty and the power of 3D imaging and how we can look at different angles, symmetries, existing asymmetries, and different views to look at the different volumization of the face, In this case, we're dealing with the cheek, also showing temporal hollows, and really looking at hollows that can create the eye drooping and the face drooping and how we can rejuvenate them. Let's go to the videos now. Okay, well, we're going to start on the patient's right side. And here, we're going to use Voluma. Now, this is the product that's from Allergan. It's using Vicross technology. It was FDA approved about 2 years ago for the mid-face. And the syringe in the product is designed exactly for that. And here, what I'm doing is what I call the lift and tack technique. And we're lifting the skin along the zygomatic bone. And I'm placing depots of product, about 0.1 ml to 0.2 ml, along the zygomatic bone. And that lifts the jawline. The product was designed for this level of use. And if you ever have the product in your hand or get to play with it in some way, you can see it's very sticky. And what it does is designed to lift the skin and the fascial layers, and that's why I'm lifting and placing the product down. Now, I want it to look as natural as possible, so I focus first on the high lateral cheek, because no one will know the patient's had a procedure. It will lift the jawline, and it will give that high, beautiful cheek. Now, once I've filled the high lateral cheek, a lot of times it's nice to address the under eye, and I'm using a very fine insulin BD syringe, same product, we're using Voluma, on the periosteal level along the orbital bone. And it, of course, we cleanse the area, most important, and then we place it down in the deeper layers to lift and to create a smooth transition between the cheek and the under eye. Because remember, the bone around the eye gets resorbed, especially in women, and the fat pad herniates, and there becomes a gap there. There's a lot of technical information there, but that's the simplest way to explain it. So a lot of people come up with the primary issue of filling underneath the eye or the tear trough, when the reality is they need mid-face with a little tiny bit of what's called the tear trough. And if there's a lot of skin, a lot of problems, then an upper lower surgical blepharoplasty is preferable. So that's Voluma. Now, here we go to Restylane Lyft. This is a product that we've had for years, so we know it well. It was recently FDA approved for the midface also. Notice I'm using a micro cannula technique here, and I'm going back and forth with a 27 gauge 1.5 inch cannula. And because of the length, I can reach many places distant from where I enter. So I start in the high cheek, create a beautiful high lateral cheek, and that expansion of tissue in that fat layer and building of that cheek will therefore pick the jawline up via volume. And I'm moving it back and forth, and it's thought that maybe this stimulates collagen growth, but also because it's a blunt-tipped instrument, there's not a lot of bruising or irritation or even pain to the patient, because the pain fibers are on the exterior part of the skin, so there's only one opening through the skin versus multiple injection openings. And the microcannula goes around the vessels and nerves, which is also thought to be a safer method and preferable at this point. And for this product, this is how we use it. So different methods. Now, how do we get to the under eye with this? Well, this is what I do. I use a micro cannula, come from a second approach, and I come up to the under eye and the tear trough area, because neither Voluma nor Restylane Lyft have a tendency to draw water in, which is great around the eye. So we can then fill these areas and smooth that transition zone and get a nice, high, beautiful filled cheek with a beautiful looking under eye. And here we see the before and afters. And on the left is prior to injection, on the right is after injection. And you can just see a rejuvenated look. Here I'm pointing to the under eye region, where there's a smoother transition to that tear trough. And here I'm pointing to that angular area on the cheek that just triangulates the face and helps pick up the jawline. Here's our right side of the patient, which is where we injected the Voluma. You can see a nice, beautiful cheek, a better transition to the under eye, and look at the jawline. It's just sharper and more defined, and the eye goes there to tell us that that's a more youthful look. So the jawline had a nice result as well. And here is our patient's left side
and a Restylane lift. And look at the light reflection on the right side. It just shows a higher, more beautiful, defined, model-like cheek. And that is the results of the fillers.
So thanks for watching the Cheek Challenge. I'm now calling out three doctors, and we look forward to their videos. Dr. Ed Zimmerman of Las Vegas, Dr. Greg Lawrence of Germantown Aesthetics, and also Dr. Shinobe Aguilera from Florida. We look forward to their great videos and continuing the Cheek Challenge.